Now, little kids and the danger of hard hits in youth football. There's been growing awareness of the risks of head injury for those who play football at the high school level and higher, particularly at the professional level. But new research shows that young players may be knocking each other down with more force than many realize. Special correspondent Stone Phillips produced this report for his own website, stonephillipsreports.com.
There he goes, zooming down the field.
These 7 and 8 year old boys played football for the Auburn Eagles, a rec league team in Montgomery County, Virginia. They're watching highlights from a memorable season.
Touchdown!
Going all the way! He's gonna make it!
Dive!
Memorable because last fall their team took part in a groundbreaking study, the first of its kind on head impact in youth football, which accounts for 70% of those playing tackle football in this country.
If you look at the NFL, you're talking about 2,000 players, college 100,000, 1.3 million in high school, with 3.5 million youth, 6 to 13-year-olds. We know a lot about the adult. We don't know much at all about this youth population.
Stephon Duma conducted the study. He's a professor of biomedical engineering at Virginia Tech and the leading researcher in the field of injury biomechanics. The testing he does here is aimed at engineering better, safer designs for the auto industry, the military, even toy companies. Learning about the limits of human tolerance for impact and injury. For years, Duma has also been focused on football helmets and player safety. His youth study with the Auburn Eagles began by providing the team with new helmets, 7 of them outfitted with sensors to measure hits to the head. The technology isn't new, but applying it to kids as young as 7 and 8 is.
So how does the helmet system work?
What we do is we take a series of 6 accelerometers, a battery, and a wireless transmitter.
These are the sensors right here.
These are the red accelerometers. And we put it in the crown of the top part of the helmet. Here for the youth, it's shown in black. So these accelerometers measure the head motion. And the transmitter transmits to the computer on the sideline, so we record every impact, every practice and game.
So if I hit this helmet right here,
right,
we'll see it on the computer.
That's right. And there you go. So you have a top impact, 27.4 Gs.
You're going to hear a lot about G in this report. It's the unit for measuring acceleration. In this case, acceleration of the brain caused by sudden impact from a hit on a football field. Duma says you can reach 5 G by jogging or doing jumping jacks. 15 to 20 G in a really aggressive pillow fight, and 40 G heading a soccer ball. Using this helmet testing device, he demonstrated what an 80 G impact is like. Duma says 80 G is a big hit in college football, and he knows because over 9 seasons, he's wired helmets and recorded more than 150,000 head impacts among players at Virginia Tech, the first college to use the system. The data helped Duma understand what makes a safer helmet. For Virginia Tech's team doctor, the instant readout on the sideline is an invaluable tool.
I kind of think of it almost like a little bit of an early warning system.
Gunnar Rolandson's beeper goes off anytime there's a hit of 98 G or above. That's a red flag for possible concussion.
And that's somebody that I could potentially pull off the field, bring him to the sideline right away, and get an evaluation. You know, at any time.
Rolandson, who works closely with Duma, says taking their college research model to youth football was overdue.
Sort of the standard thought process was that, well, gee whiz, you know, they're small, they don't weigh very much, they don't run very fast, and so, you know, it's kind of like, you know, beehive football. Everybody kind of runs around the ball, some of the kids fall over, not a big deal. But, you know, we needed to know, is it a big deal or not?
So Duma's research team spent a season, every practice and all 8 games with the Eagles, collecting impact data from the 7 players wearing the special helmets.
All right, can we do this?
No, sir!
The Eagles coach welcomed the Virginia Tech study.
I was very excited about it when Stephon let me know that it was the first time anything had been done to evaluate the hits that these kids are seeing on an everyday basis, whether in practice or in games.
In college, John Clark was old school, a tough guy who played through injury and, he thinks, possibly concussion.
Those are defensive ends.
Wow.
He says that's not an option for his players.
Who do you think would have that right?
Do you think about concussion differently with your son playing?
I do. I'm not thinking about myself anymore. My son Trey, if he would have received a hard hit and he felt foggy or was acting a little bit differently, obviously I would pull him.
He wouldn't get the son you play through this routine.
Absolutely not. And none of the coaches on my team would ever do that.
So what did the study find? The research documented a total of 753 impacts.
If you look at the course of a season, the average player in this youth football from 6 to 8 years old sustains about 107 impacts over the course of that season. And you can compare that to high school, which is about 500, and then college, which is about 1,000 a season.
What kind of magnitudes did you see?
Well, the magnitudes are very interesting. The median impact is 15 Gs. So that means half the impacts are above 15 Gs, half are below 15 Gs.
Remember, Duma says 15 G is like an aggressive pillow fight, and in the same range where the vast majority of youth hits occurred.
There you go, DeCorn! Good job, Coco!
I'm not really concerned about the 10 to 20 G range. I think people see that in their everyday life. But when you start to get into the 30, 40, you start to think maybe these add up over time. We don't know, but that's sort of a cumulative risk of injury. When you talk about acute injury, now you're talking into the 80, 90, 100 G range.
Those higher level hits are the ones that really interest Duma because they carry greater risk. The study recorded 38 impacts of 40 G or greater. Significantly, almost every one of those hits happened during practice.
The impacts and the number of impacts that were into the 40, 50, 60 G range were more than I would have expected.
How do these compare with what you see with the Virginia Tech players?
Some of the impacts that we collected in youth are similar to the big impacts you'll see on a college field. We saw, for example, 6 impacts over 80 Gs.
Come on, Daniel.
80 Gs starts to get in the lower range of what we would consider to be a risk of concussion. That's a very high level acceleration. Even in the college football, you're into the 95th percentile range. We'll see 5 or 6 or 7 impacts at that level through the whole game. So you see it, but not very often.
What?
Duma explains that because they lack the protective neck and chest muscles of older players, the youngsters are sort of like bobblehead dolls. So as he put it, almost every hit is like a surprise hit.
Because the neck is so small and so underdeveloped relative to the head size, that's one of the reasons I think we're seeing some of these larger accelerations, because there's no muscle tone that's affecting any of this.
What's that? Hey, that's a good pop! Now come on!
With the kids, when you start seeing 50, 60, 70, 80 G blows, you're just going, wow. I mean, that is really impressive in terms of the load that's occurring. And again, you've got a young athlete, developing brain, subject to those kinds of loads. So it's concerning.
Fortunately, none of the Eagles suffered a concussion this season.
Why is it that some impacts will cause a concussion and others of the same magnitude will not?
Well, there's two basic reasons. One is direction and how you're hit is a big, big factor. Getting hit with a lateral impact versus a front impact, those are issues. Our brain has different tolerances in different directions. The other issue is everybody's very different. Our genetic makeup and ability to withstand impact is different. It's different for our whole body.
The effect of an 80 G hit on a college player versus the effect of an 80 G hit on a 7 or 8 year old. How does it compare?
80 Gs on an adult, 80 Gs on a kid, it's still 80 Gs. It's a lot of energy. How many of those they can sustain, what's happening in the brain, especially at the cellular level, that's a real unknown right now.
Duma's research found that among those 6 impacts, 80 G or greater, there was one remarkably big hit.
The highest one we measured was 100 G, which puts you right in the middle average of a concussion.
Is that surprising to you?
It's very surprising. And that's one of the reasons we wanted to collect the data, was because no one knew what this would look like. We had no idea how hard the kids would hit. And there's a lot of discussion now that maybe we need to change the design of a youth helmet. Now we have some data that would back up some of those design characteristics.
Including information on where each hit landed. The helmet system tracks all of that.
What you see in the youth that you don't see in the adult is almost always you have this helmet-to-helmet contact because the head's so much a large part of their body. We don't have the head-to-ground impacts that you would see in a college level. So mostly it's helmet-to-helmet and right on the front of the shell.
Are children more susceptible to head injury?
It's a great question. On the one hand, children recover quicker, they can recover and sustain injuries a little better. But on the other hand, the brain is still developing. It's not fully formed, it's not fully wired, so we just don't understand what that long-term effect is.
Virginia Tech opened the doors to its football locker room.
Wow.
So Duma could present his findings to the Eagles and their parents.
This is what the data looks like. This is what we get on the sidelines. We do linear acceleration, so how the head moves linear, and we also look at rotational, so the kind of the rotating, twisting moment. We capture that for every single impact.
He and Dr. Brolinson walked parents through the study and what the results could teach them.
The one area where we have, I think, a huge opportunity to reduce the risk of concussion, reduce the risk of head injuries, I think occurs in practice. What we need to do, I think, is be very, very cautious with any kind of live or hitting drills and mitigate that risk in the situation that we can control, which is really on the practice field.
What we can do is we can take this data and use it to drive future designs. How do you want to develop these helmets for the youth versus an adult? How do we make it lighter? How do we change the properties? Do we change the shape, the padding, to tailor a helmet for little kids as opposed to just wearing basically an adult helmet?
What did you think about what you heard?
I thought I was shocked by the amount of impact that these little kids can put out.
A lot of times people don't think about the young kids hitting this hard. And honestly, I didn't realize it either. And, you know, and the data don't lie.
So it was one of the things I was really worried about. And to see the data is, it's surprising for them to be so small, but actually a really good thing.
I was surprised that we didn't have any injuries, actually, by watching some of the hits these kids took. These studies need to be done at this level, especially if these kids continue to play.
Come on over here. We're about to play a game, guys.
The findings of the Virginia Tech study may encourage youth teams across the country to take a closer look at ways to make games and especially practices safer. And it will hardly quiet the debate about whether kids this age should be playing tackle football at all. For Eagles coach John Clark, who lives and breathes the game, the study delivered a high-impact message about making football safer to make it better.
I believe the game will flourish because of the study.
Ready, set, hike!
There's no reason to be afraid of the information. The information is real. It's there. It's what we do with it.
Auburn Mike's on three.
One, two, three, five!
All right, good job.
You can ask Stone Phillips your questions about the research on young football players. Join us for a live chat at noon Eastern Time tomorrow. You can find the details on our homepage.